So, in the last class, we have done various connectives, okay, for classical logic. So, lastly, we are doing implication. Implication. And there we define this implication like this: if P imply Q, so that means we have what? A bar union B, no, where P is in A and B is in Q. Sorry, P is in A and Q is in B. So it was A bar union B, and the truth value of this P to Q we wrote as truth value of P bar union Q, and we also gave you the truth table for these. And others also, equivalence, okay, disjunction, conjunction, all those we have done. Okay. Now, if I this I can do by Venn diagram also, you can see the truthness here. So, if your A is this, this is A and this is B. Now, A bar union B, A bar union B, what will be that? A bar union B. So, what? So, A bar is from here and except this portion. So, we will have this as the truth set. This. Okay? Now, so this was for one universal set X, where this P and Q are in X. Okay? That means A and B sets were in X, this A and B set. Okay? Now, suppose we have two different universe X and Y, okay, then we suppose that X belongs to X. So, if X belongs to X, then Y belongs to Y, and this we can write in terms of a relation that you relation means that relation we have done, but this relation will be from A cross B and union A bar cross Y. This I can represent in terms of relation A cross B union A cross A bar cross Y, and this X, so this I can write for by this relation, and this is called actually linguistic rule. I can write this as if X then Y, where X belongs to A superset of X, X belongs to X, and Y belongs to proper set of Y, and Y belongs to Y. And in linguistic way we can write if X then Y. Okay? So if it is the, and actually this is what? A bar union B. So, in this case, if you have two universe, so I can have the diagram like this. So, if I have this, suppose this is your X, this is your Y, okay. So, suppose I have like this, because I have two universes, so X and Y, okay. So, now if suppose this is your A and this is your B, so A bar intersects, sorry, A bar's union B. A bar union B. So, B is this and A bar union B. So, I will have only left out this two and we will have this. This is the truth set for this. Understood? So, if A, if X then Y. Okay? And X is in A, Y is in B. So, now if we have another linguistic rule like if X then Y else C, and suppose your this Y and okay, if X then Y else C, let me write that, then I will explain. Suppose now I write the rule, linguistic rule, as if X then Y else C. Else, if X then Y else else C, or I should write if A. Okay, let me write, suppose if A then B else C, then it is better. If A then B else C. Actually here also it should be if A then B, sorry, because I am having the set A and B in universal set X and Y. If A then B. So here if A then B else C, and remember this A is in X, this B is in Y, and this C is also in Y. We have two universes, X, capital X and capital Y. Now this statement or this rule I can write as if A then B, and if, see this, if A bar then C. See these two statements now. If A then B else C means what? If A then B, and if A bar its complement then C. Okay? Now I can write in set form. How? We know that if A then B means A bar union B. So I can write this as A bar union B, and this and, this notation I have used, and A bar of bar. Okay? So I let us write first A bar of bar and then union C. And you are correct that A bar bar is actually what? A only. So I can write this as A union B and, sorry, A bar. A bar union B and A union C. So you see, this was your for if A then B. A bar union B. Now let us see what you are getting as a diagram. If A then B else C. That means A bar union B we have. Now let us take C here, because C is in Y. So I can have here C. So let me draw that, and you see after combining what you get, the truth set. Okay? So suppose this is your Y, this is your X. So don't take the size, but the understand the thing actually, okay? That should be actually same size. So this is your A, this is your B, and this is your C. Okay? This is your B, this is your C, and this is your A. So now I have to find first A union C. So A union C will be what? This is your A and union C. Okay? A union C. Now I have to take AND of this two. AND of this two. So what reason will get? See? What reason will get? So if you understood, I can erase this. Okay? So I will have finally for if A then B else C, I have, this is Y, X. So it was, this is what, A, this is B, this is C. I have to take AND. AND means C, this and this, and this and this. That's all. So I have only, so this is your if A then B else C. Okay? But remember, here we have actually supposed that B intersection C is null. Okay? And your homework will be, if B intersection C is not null, then what will be that? Okay? Yes? So this is your truth sets for that if A then B or if A then B else C. Yes? Have you heard about tautologies? Tautologies. Anybody? What is tautology? If I have compound proposition, I already discussed about compound proposition, simple proposition. Compound proposition we get by combining your simple proposition by connectives. Okay? Suppose I have propositions P and Q. Okay? I combine, I get compound proposition and or okay, some compound proposition I get. Now, the truthness of the compound propositions, if it is always true, if it is always true, irrespective of the truthness of the individual simple propositions. Okay? Suppose a compound propositions you have made with simple propositions. Now, simple propositions, this P may have true false, either true or false, this one may be either true or false, but if after connectives, connecting whatever means compound proposition we get, if it is always true, irrespective of the truthness of these simple propositions, then we so say that that compound proposition has tautology. And this is very much used in expert system. Okay? This is used actually in expert system. And I hope everybody know what is expert system nowadays. So we have two important tautologies that we will do. One is modus ponens and other one is modus tollens. What are these? You see, I will write modus ponens is A and A to B, A imply B. So that A and A, all these connectives you know now. A and A implication B, whole implication B. This B bar and A implication B to, now you will see, first one I will prove first and you will see that this is always true. Whatever truth values of these A and B you will take. That is why these are called tautology. Okay? And remember that T, truthness of universal set X is 1 and truthness of null set is 0. This you remember. So, using these two, I will prove this one by one. And you will say by see by truth table also that it will be always true, whatever truthness you take for A and B. Okay? So, let us start with this modus ponens. Okay? It is very easy to prove. So, first one is modus ponens, that is A and A implication B. So, this I can write as A and, because you know A implication B, what is that? A bar union B implication B. No problem, I have just used the formula. Now, I can open that by distributive law. So, you should write here by implication rule. So, you have to write by implication rule, how you get this? By implication rule. Now, I will do distributive and this. So, I will get A and A bar and union A and B implication B. Again, write distributive property. Okay? Now, what is A and A bar? Phi. Phi, I am not writing those steps, okay? A and A bar is phi. Phi union A and B is A and B. Okay? So, this will get A and B and then implication B. Is it okay? Now, again this, suppose this is Z implication B, so this bar union B. So, I will get A and B bar union B. So, then I can write this A complement or B complement union B. Okay? Now, I can use associativity. So, I can write A bar or B bar union B. So, this you again write by associativity. Then A bar or X. A bar or X is X. No, X. X. Now, if I take truth values of all these, So what will be truth value of x? Is 1. So whatever truth values of a and b are there, you will have always truth value of this statement as true. That's why it is called tautology. Okay, clear? Yes. Now let us see by truth table. Same, you should get all one, then only you will say, either way you can do. Okay. So let us make now the truth table. So I have A implication B, A and A implication B, and the last one. Final one is A and A implication B, implication B. Okay? Yes? So now this A and B are two simple propositions, I, and we have true and false two. So how many? I already discussed four combinations is possible. So 0 0 0 1 1 0 1, or we can write false 2, whatever, because I have already in classical logic I am taking 1 as true, 0 as false. So now A implication B, it is 1, I have already discussed in the last class. 0 1 1 1 0 0, true cannot imply false. This is now A and this, that means
zero.
Minimum.
Zero.
Minimum as per our definition. So it is 0 0, this is why 1 0, then it is 1. Now this imply B, 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 1 0 0 1 and 1 1 1. So you are seeing, whatever combination you are taking for this A and B means truthness. Okay, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, you are always getting 1 1 1. So this is this, whatever compound proposition you have, if you have all the combinations values as truth values as 1 1 1, then it is a tautology. Okay. So let us do next the second one and try yourself. What should I do? Okay, so modus, what modus? Tollens. So what is that? B bar and A implication B, A bar. So this I can write B bar and A implication B, you know by your definition, that is A bar union B, implication A bar. Okay. Now I can have your, sorry, this is not A, this is AND. B bar AND A bar union B. Now I can have associativity. So this I can write as B bar AND A bar, then union B bar AND B, correct? Implication A bar. Now this you are seeing, B bar and B is phi. So this union phi is B bar and A bar. So B bar and A bar, implication A bar. So again use the formula for implication. So bar of this, yes, so it will be B bar and A bar whole bar union A bar. It will be what? A, this is okay. Why whole bar? Union A bar. Then some mistake. No, B bar and A bar, then B bar and A bar, this is B union A, this is correct. Yes, B or A, So A union A bar, now I can use again associativity, that is your A, and then you have B, B or X, and this is equal to X, and this gives T of X as 1. So this way, whatever combination you take, you will get true. Now let us have here A to B, then we need B bar. Here we need one B bar also. Okay, so let me erase this and we will write A, B, A bar, B bar, then A to B, A implication B, then B bar and A implication B, and then B bar and A implication B, implication A bar. So this I have to find. So the combinations are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So A bar will be 1, 1, 0, 0. B bar is 1, 0, 1, 0. Then A to B, A implication B, so 0, 0 is 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. So B bar and this, this is 1, 0, 0, 0. Now this to A bar, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, this is 1, this is 1. So whatever you take, this is your true. Okay, so these are very well used in export system, because sometimes you need to have some combination of the simple propositions. Okay, if this, if then else, etc., whatever. So you should get true, means your system should not fail, should not have failed. Okay, it should be true always. So similar to tautology, again we should have opposite also, contradiction, means some compound statement always false. So that is called contradiction. Okay. Contradiction. So that means you have compound proposition which is always false, irrespective of the truthness of the simple propositions. Understood? Whatever the truthness of the simple proposition A, B, C, whatever. So if your result compound proposition is always false, then it is called contradiction. Do you have any example? Do you have any example? A and A bar. Yes. Yes. A and means A intersection A bar. See, let us try A and A bar. So A will have how many combination, means possibilities? 1 or 0? 1 or 0. A bar will have 0 and 1. So with what will be A intersection A bar? 0, 0. Always false. Any other? You can define. Any other? Very simple. A intersection phi. You can see A intersection phi. There are many contradictions. Okay. So if you want to fail some machine, so you can do this. Okay. Okay. So for failure, suppose you want to fail someone, so if you want to fail in the exam, you have to fail some courses, no? So it will be fail. And if you want to pass, so all combinations should be passed, no? True. Whether it is system, machine, or human's actions. Okay? So if you understood this, next comes equivalence. And I have already defined equivalence. And I denoted this as like two arrows. So we have P equivalence Q. When P equivalence Q? When either both of them means simple propositions are true or both of them are false. Same truth value, either true or false. Okay? So, for example, suppose I write one proposition, triangle is equilateral, and second is triangle is equiangular. Both are true or false or whatever, so you will get these as equivalents. Okay? Let us take more an important example for this, then you will be understand. So let us take, suppose consider an universe, X as these numbers 1, natural numbers, okay, 1 less than equal to n less than equal to 8. And I have P proposition as n is an even number. And Q, we have 3 less than equal to n less than equal to 7 and n is not equal to 6. So, what about truthness of P equivalence Q? Understood the problem? I have X universal set as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 8. I have P as n is even number. So, whatever truth set, truth value of P, truth set actually, what will be those? N is even number. So, 2, 4, 6, 8. Only this as per your X, capital X. Okay? Similarly, I can have TQ 3 to 7, but it may not be 6. So, it will be 3, 4, 5 and 7. Okay? I have to find truthness of P equivalence Q, and you know the definition. Okay, let me have that this P bar and Q bar truthness. Okay? So, truth set of P bar will be what? Accept these values. Okay? So, it will be 1, then 3, 5, 7. This only P bar, T P bar. Okay? Now, T Q bar, we have 6 and we have 6 and 8 also. Why not 8? 1 also. 1, 2, yes. We have all, because I have the X as 1 to 8. 1 to 8. So, I have 1, 2, 6, 8. These are there, 4 elements. 1, 2, 6, 8. T of Q bar. Now, you have to find T of this P equivalence Q. See, P equivalence Q, so you told that this is actually what? Either both of them are true or both of them are false. So, I can write this as TP intersection TQ or TP bar intersection TQ bar. Yes? Correct? Now you see TP intersection TQ is what? Only 4. Only 4. So, I have only 4 and or 1. Only 1. And this is or, that means I have the set as 1. So, truthness of this equivalence P to Q is 1, 4. Now, let us verify. For 1, 1 you see P is not an even number, means 1 is not an even number. Moreover, 1 is not here, 3 to 7 not, so both are false. For this 1, both are false. Okay, one condition satisfied. Now, see what about 4? 4 is an even number. It is there in P. 4 is here. Understood? So, this is the truth set for this. So, like that, you can have different problems. Okay? So, we will do them in the next class. Okay? Thank you.